What do you think's the toughest test for your boy Tom Brady in the Bucks?
The defending Super Bowl champions. Of course. Look, you look at this. The Chiefs are the defending Super Bowl champs. Yes, they had to come back in all those games. They had that nice revamped defense, too. But that just shows that they can. They hadn't been there before, all the way to the Super Bowl. Andy Reid winning a Super Bowl, the whole thing, they had to get over the jitters. Now they have. They should be more poised, meaning they may not have to come back, meaning those late points are going to tack on to leads. Now consider this. There's also a personal motivation. I don't care. I know it's a different team, a different season, the whole thing, and it's Belichick and Brady. Now it's just Brady. Patrick Mahomes is about to beat Tom Brady. Oh, no, he's beating the Patriots defense. Stop, I understand. But psychologically, emotionally, he's about to beat Tom Brady to get to the Super Bowl. And because of a pre-snap penalty, Brady gets the ball back, and then Mahomes never gets to touch the ball again, and Brady and the Pats advance. So there's actually a revenge factor for Mahomes on top of everything else. When you know, as opposed to, if you look at, like, a matchup with the Saints, actually, the Saints are the team with something to lose, right? The Bucs are the team that can play free. The Saints are the dominant team in the division. The Bucs are the upstarts of the division, really, right now. So in fact, I think that because the Chiefs are a better team, but also because of the direction of the motivation, the Chiefs are going to be tougher for the Bucs than the Saints.
I disagree with you, but it's basically just because of an old adage, Marcus, that I lean on, and I'm going to look at division rivalries as usually being the toughest games on your schedule, particularly when both teams are elite, which clearly New Orleans is this year and Tampa Bay in all likelihood shall be. The other thing that I take into consideration, Max and Marcus, is the fact that the Chiefs, even though they're going to win a vast majority of their games when Patrick Mahomes is behind center, at Arrowhead Stadium, they run you out of the state of Missouri. On the road, they beat you. But a lot of the times, the games are competitive. You know, it's close-knit contests and things of that nature. And Patrick Mahomes and Tyreek Hill and those boys pull out the heroics. And this game would be at Tampa. Okay, so I think that on Brady's home turf now, with Gronk, Howard, Brady, Evans, Godwin, and those boys and going up against the reigning defending Super Bowl champions, the motivation is going to be high anyway, but it's clearly going to elevate once Patrick Mahomes and the crew come strolling into Tampa Bay. Then I get a look at the Saints, and that's why that's my choice. I think that Tampa Bay is the toughest. The Saints are the toughest matchup on Tampa's schedule. You're talking about the NFC South. You're talking about the New Orleans Saints reigning supreme. You're talking about Cameron Jordan coming on the air yesterday with Greeny on Get Up. And what did he say? Greeny said when Tampa Bay, if I remember correctly, he said when Tampa Bay acquired Tom Brady, what was the first thought to run through your mind? And Cameron said that Drew Brees elected to stay with us. That's what. We still got Drew Brees. We good. Because Drew Brees is what's going to be required to upend and offset whatever Tampa Bay led by Tom Brady is going to throw in your direction. Having to go into that Mercedes-Benz Dome, a.k.a. the Superdome in New Orleans, okay? Having to go and show up there to perform against that New Orleans Saints team with Michael Thomas, with Alvin Kamara. Now you've got Emmanuel Sanders as well. Plus, it's a division rivalry. Plus, it's Drew Brees and Tom Brady both chasing history. Remember when Drew Brees broke the, you know, I think it was the completion record or whatever. Tom Brady talked about what he did, congratulating him and saying, well, you know what, I got mine's coming. They're clearly competing with each other on a friendly basis. From a legacy perspective, I think all of those things lend itself towards Tampa Bay having the New Orleans Saints as their toughest competition for this upcoming season.
I applaud both of these teams that y'all picked, and two things can be true. Max, on your side, obviously you look at who is the toughest team, and you would perceivably, everybody would say the team with Patrick Mahomes as quarterback. But toughest matchup, I think I got to go with Stephen A. Because being in this league for a long time, your divisional rivals, your divisional opponents are always tougher because you're more familiar. And it's a harder game to win. And you can ask anybody. Like last year, we saw this come into play. We talked about Carson Wentz having a bunch of guys that we had no idea play wide receiver. The fact that Philip Philadelphia plays the Dallas Cowboys every year, the fact that the Eagles play them every year and there's some familiarity with coaching staffs, how guys like to beat you, how they will approach a game, you just have more information, which most times makes for a tougher matchup. So I get it, Max. Like, this is not one of them things to go off and go crazy about. Conventional mind will tell you the team that won the Super Bowl with everybody returning and the best quarterback in the NFL should be the toughest matchup. But when you're sitting down in a game plan meeting room going throughout the week and the fact that you have a relative known about the team that you're playing against, it just makes it a much tougher game to win. And that's no excuses. I think most guys would agree with that if you asked around the league, is it tougher to play guys within your division or tougher to play the one-offs of guys that you don't really face that much throughout the course of years?
Well, I mean, if you're talking about
and to
effort,
mention the Saints is
okay,
a very good team.
A lot of times divisional rivalries, those games seem to be close. But I don't think you'd say it's tougher to win because this is just – sports is a zero-sum game. There's a winner and a loser. Occasionally you have a tie in the NFL. So that means if it's tougher for one team to win, it's easier for the other, right? Like, it can't be tougher for both to win. Someone's going to win. So the question is, who does that affect in a divisional rivalry more? In this case, I believe the Saints are the better team. They're also the more established team. But because of that, there's also more pressure on them. And Tom Brady and company can actually play a little looser. They're the team that is helped by the fact that it's a divisional rivalry game. The team that's hurt there, I believe, is
Please.
The Saints. So the tougher matchup, to me, is the Chiefs because they're just a better team and the motivation
Max.
Is more for the Chiefs. Patrick Mahomes
what
versus
the hell
Tom Brady.
Are you talking? Max.
Max, hold on, Pastor Spears. Max Kellerman, could you please take your Columbia Ivy League verbiage and come down to earth with the rest of us, brother? Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.